الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي
ربه أني مسني الضر وأنت أرحم الراحمين. قال ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. وأيوب إذ نادى ربه أني مسني الضر وأنت أرحم الراحمين. قال ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. وأيوب إذ نادى ربه أني مسني الضر وأنت أرحم الراحمين. قال ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. Oh Allah, forgive us for our wrongdoings.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. I seek refuge in Allah from Shaitan the rejected. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. With the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful. Brothers and sisters in Islam, distinguished guests and participants of today's seminar, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Peace be on you all and Allah's blessings and His mercy. Today's lecture is entitled What Al-Quran Says About Iblees and Shaitan. Before I give you the program format for this evening, I would first like to request Mr. Muhammad Ali to come up to the rostrum and start the program with a recitation from Al-Quran. Mr. Muhammad Ali.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا فاثبتوا واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون. وأطيعوا الله ورسوله ولا تنازعوا فتفشلوا وتذهب ريحكم واصبروا إن
translation of Surah Al-Anfal, verses 45 through 49. O you who believe, when you meet a force, be firm and call Allah in remembrance much, that you may prosper. And obey Allah and His Messenger, and fall into no disputes, lest you lose heart and your power depart. And be patient and persevering, for Allah is with those who patiently persevere. And be not like those who started from their homes, and be not like those who started from their homes insolently and to be seen of men, and to hinder men from the path of Allah. For Allah compasseth round about all that they do. Remember, Shaitan made their acts seem alluring to them and said, no one among men can overcome you this day while I am near you. But when the two forces met and came in sight of each other, he turned on his heels and said, I am clear of you. I see what you see not. I fear Allah, for Allah is strict in punishment. When the hypocrites say, and those in whose hearts is a disease, these people, their religion has misled them. But if any trust in Allah, behold, Allah is exalted in might, wise. I would just like to take a moment of your time. The booklets which you're holding have within them the ayats from Al-Quran. On the right-hand side of the page, you'll find the ayats in Arabic, and on the corresponding page, its English translation. These ayats have been placed in the same chronological order as they will appear in Mr. Muhammad Sheikh's lecture. For additional ease and viewing, we have made arrangements in the back of the stage with an overhead projector. So please follow through the lecture of Mr. Sheikh with the ayats that you're holding between your hands. I request Mr. Muhammad Sheikh to come up to the rostrum and deliver his lecture entitled What Al-Quran Says About Iblees and Shaitan. Mr. Muhammad Sheikh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be unto you, all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Before I start the topic, what the Quran says about Iblis or Shaitan, I would like the Muslim among all of us should recite with me. So I begin with A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful. The lecture is what the Al-Quran says about Iblis, Balasa, the devil, and the Shaitan, translated as Satan. Ladies and gentlemen, you will hear what you are going to hear. I will give you in my short little words, then you can verify by the booklet given to you. But before I speak this, I would like to know that what you are going to hear, that the confrontation of Allah, I mean the Iblis confronts Allah, and he speaks in first person to Allah, giving his view why
he would not follow what he's told to do so in first person. Secondly, how Shaitan misguides mankind. How Shaitan misguides Adam and his pair, and they are thrown out of the garden. Thirdly, Prophet Ayub alayhi salam, he was distressed by the Shaitan, and what was the remedy given to him? What was the remedy given to Prophet Ayub alayhi salam? Fourthly, on the day of judgment, the Shaitan will establish that he was false. He was on the falsehood. He will say himself on the day of judgment. And fourthly, what is the lesson of this lecture? The lecture, why I have chosen this lecture, and how to defend ourselves from our enemy Iblis or Shaitan. I am going to recite the ayahs of Allah, not my opinion about the devil and the Shaitan. It is what the Quran says about Iblis, Shaitan. Through the ayahs, you will understand, you will get the picture of Iblis, Shaitan. And during the course of my lecture, I will quote some references from the Bible to have a comparative view for your own understanding, that you can judge whether the Bible is the book of Allah. So you have got the common intelligence, and you can understand whether Allah is speaking or the Bible, in the Bible, who is speaking, by the verses when you hear from the Quran and from the Bible also. I will quote to have a comparison. First of all, Iblis, as you open the page, you will see Iblis means a devil wrapped up in grief. In the first page, Iblis as defined as a personality, devil wrapped up in grief, and a subordinate evil spirit at enmity with God. That is the definition. Translation of the word Iblis, the Balasa, comes from the root word Balasa, which means Iblis. And the other word is Shaitan, which means to oppose another, to turn him from his purpose, or the great adversary of man. This enemy of mankind, it is very, very difficult to identify Iblis or Shaitan, the devil and the Satan, translated. Iblis is and Shaitan are two personalities of one person, of the same one person. Meaning, when any individual is a direct confrontation with Allah, is Iblis. When any personality is in confrontation with God, with Allah, that is Iblis. And when a person is opposing man, that is Shaitan, the Satan. So that is the only difference between Iblis and Shaitan. But it is the same personality. When I will read the ayats, you will differentiate. Allah speaks about the Iblis, the devil, and also the Shaitan. Iblis, the devil, speaks in first person, opposing Allah when the Adam and is thrown out from the garden. He speaks in first person, Iblis. Shaitan is a personality which becomes later on to have enmity with man. So that is the difference. But they are one personality. So now, first of all, you're going to hear how Iblis speaks in first person and why. Surah Sa'd 38, 71 ayah. إِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي خَالِقٌ بَشَرًا مِّن طِينٍ فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِن رُّوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ اسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. When your Lord said to the angels, surely I am the creator of human being from clay. When I have made him even and breathed into him from my spirit, then fall down prostrating for him. So the angels prostrated all of them together, except Iblis, who sought greatness and became from the rejectors. Now this is the beginning of confrontation, that Allah says to the angels, when your Lord said to the angels, surely I am the creator of human being from clay. Allah creates mankind human from clay. When He creates that, He says, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَقْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. When I have made Him even and breathe into Him from my spirit, then fall down prostrating for Him. Now when I say human being, it is not a structure of clay should come in your mind. I and everybody sitting in the hall are human beings. Aren't you? Human beings. Our origin is the clay. But we are not a physical structure of clay standing. We are not. We are human beings. So Allah is saying, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ, when I have made this human being even, meaning corrected him, perfected him in his sight, when Allah makes that human being all right, He says, and when I breathe into him my spirit, then fall down prostrating for him. After making that personality human being all right, in psychologically appear in Allah's sight, He's made all right, then Allah breathe and into him from my spirit. And what is the spirit of Allah is the Quranic understanding. The spirit means the essence of the message of Allah's ayat. Essence of the Quranic essence, the spirit, the ruh, is the essence of the Allah's ayats. It was not like blowing air into the human being. It was the spirit. It was the spirit by virtue Allah inspired that personality human being. Every individual has got the spirit of Allah within him, but it has to be inspired from Allah. It has to be inspired from Allah. So that human being, Allah made him all right, and then He breathed into him His spirit. فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَقْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي, from my spirit. فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ, so fall down prostrating to Him. So that means that human being is containing the spirit or the essence of Allah. That human being contains the spirit or the essence of Allah's ayahs, Allah's message. And that is inspired into that human being. So, فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ. No, when that spirit is being inspired, that man is being inspired by the spirit, Allah asks angels to bow down. That means Allah is asking to bow to a personality containing the spirit. Bashar and the spirit, meaning human being and spirit. Allah asks the angels to bow down after He has inspired the spirit into him. He has breathed into him that spirit. So Allah asks the angels to bow down when that personality who contained the spirit of Allah, the essence of Allah's message. It was not a human being. Allah asked him, just a man, to bow down. When I breathe into him the spirit, essence of Allah, then you bow down. So the angels, فَسَدَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ كُلُّ مَجْمَعُونَ, the angels bow down to that personality containing the spirit, إِلَّا Iblis, except Iblis. Now you must be very careful. The Iblis will exclude the spirit. إِلَّا Iblis اسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ, except the Iblis who sought greatness and became from the rejectors. Surah Sa'd 38 and 75 and 76 in continuation. So now Allah is going to question Iblis for not prostrating. قَالَ يَا إِبْلِيسُ مَا مَنَعَكَ أَن تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيَّ أَسْتَكْبَرْتَ أَمْ كُنْتَ مِنَ الْعَالِينَ. قَالَ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْهُ خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ تِينٍ. He said, O Iblis, Allah said, He said, O Iblis, What prevented you to prostrate for what I have created with my hands? Do you see greatness? Or are you from the higher class? Do you think you are a high class? Or you see greatness? So he answers Iblees, and he speaks in first person. Qala ana khayrun min khalaqtani min narin wa khalaqtahu min teen. He said, I am better one from him. I am better from him. You have created me from fire and created him from clay. So this is the statement speaking in first person, the Iblees, the devil. He says, I am the better one from him, the comparison. And he says, you have freed me from fire, and you have freed him for him from clay. He excludes the spirit. He excludes the spirit. Allah said, when I breathe into him of my spirit, then you fall down prostrating. He doesn't talk about the spirit. He's comparing between the words, the creation words, that he is made of the fire and man is made of thin. He is made of fire. So remember, whenever the Quranic ayat is being rehearsed, it is the spirit you have to bow down to. It is not man. It is not man you are having problems. You have to bow down to the spirit of Allah. And that is contained in the ayahs. But the Iblis will not let you do it. He will always exclude the spirit of Allah. And you can see when the question and answer session, people will talk something else, not the Quranic ayat. It will always, I am delivering the ayahs with spirit and understanding, in essence. But they will question something else. So this is what Iblis does to mankind in all times. He will exclude the spirit, the essence, what was being delivered, what was the personality of Iblis. So very carefully you must understand when he says, قَالَ إِبْلِيسُ مَا مَنَكَ أَنْ تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيَّ أَسْتَكْبَرْتَ أَمْ كُنْتَ مِنَ الْعَالِينَ. He said, O Iblis, what prevented you to prostrate for what I have created with my hands? Did you seek greatness? Or are you from the higher class? This is the problem. This is the problem that he thinks he's great. He himself thinks he's great. He thinks himself a higher class. So he says, قَالَ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْهُ خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ تِينٍ. He says, I am the better one from him. You have freed me from fire and freed him from clay. So remember, ladies and gentlemen, whenever you want to compare people, who's giving you these ideas? Comparison between nationalities, comparison between color, comparison between women and men, comparison between languages. Who is saying that this is superior language or that is inferior? Or this nationality is superior than the other is inferior? Anything which comes in your mind of comparison of anything is coming from the Iblis. Remember this. Whenever you think, because of my knowledge, comparison of knowledge, anything when you think you are superior and you don't want to bow to the spirit of Allah, the essence of ayahs, you are behaving under the influence of the Iblis, the devil. He won't let all the comparison is basically because of the Iblis. And inspired by the Iblis is inspiring. So I am better one from him. That is cause. So wherever the comparison are there, false standards are there in the world. You have your own self-created false standards by virtue you compare others. That's your own created standard. Who gave you that? Is it based on the Quranic ayat? So you must always be very careful when you're dealing with Allah's ayat, because you have to know the spirit, the essence. So this is how he compares all the time.